Okay, Paul, I want to talk to you about font rendering. So you visit a site, everything downloads, the HTML, the CSS, the JavaScript, but not the font for the content. What happens?
You stare at a white screen normally?
Well, it depends on the browser, you see. So in Safari, for instance, it will give you all of the layout, everything, but it will block rendering of that text.
I thought it did that in Chrome as well.
Chrome does something similar. We used to do exactly that, but we took a cue from Firefox and we decided we'll have a 3-second timeout, and then we'll render the fallback font, and when the new font comes in, we'll swap it.
Okay,
for the new one.
I definitely have two problems then.
One, you have way more than two problems, but I guess you're talking about two specific problems right
to this, yeah.
Okay.
I mean, that's all the therapy time we have for today.
Firstly, 3 seconds feels really arbitrary to me. I'm not sure where that comes from.
I trust they did research.
And then the other thing about it is switching fonts really bothers me. Like, if you're halfway through reading a sentence and then the font changes and it's got completely different metrics, then what's that?
Yeah,
that's horrible.
Words can swap from one line to another. It's
ew.
It's bad. So I think this is part of the problem, is that there is no one true answer. Like, even what we do, what Firefox does, what Opera does, it feels like a compromise, which is sometimes the worst of all worlds, right? We've got the delay, we also have the swap sometimes.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
Thankfully, a new CSS property is arriving. Well, I say it's arriving. It's been proposed.
So okay.
It's a bit early to say it's arriving.
Whee!
It's a proposal by Kenji Bayu and Ilya Grigorik. It's on GitHub at the moment.
Those two.
The worlds of performance and font combine. It's a CSS property, font rendering, and you get to pick what strategy to use. Like, you know, how long do you want to block for? Do you want to swap? Do you want to use a fallback and then swap the new font in? It also gives you the opportunity to use another technique. And this is one that we've seen pioneered by, I think it was The Guardian that did it first. They use the font if they have it, like if it's in the cache. If it's there, they'll use it. If it's not, they just go for a fallback. They download the font, but they don't swap. They download it, they put it in local storage for next time.
Okay.
But this is a great example, I think, of the extensible web, that we've seen people do this. You know, we've seen The Guardian do it, Smashing Magazine do it now as well. And other people have, we've picked up on it and think, well, let's remove the bad bits. Let's avoid the amount of code you need to write. Let's avoid the local storage bit. Let's have a CSS property for it.
Love it.
I've been at a few conferences recently.
Yes.
Right? And you know how the conference after party, it's a great place for developers to come together and chat about things. So we'll put the music really loud to really get the conversation flowing.
Exactly. So nothing says quality conversation like shouting at another human being from a couple of feet away. Perfect.
Right. So I was chatting with this guy. He was giving me his opinion on a thing. And as he was shouting, a bit of spit came out of his mouth.
Where did it land?
In my ear. It was a shot that Luke Skywalker would have been proud of. Like, it just went right in the hall.
Use the force, Luke.
Yeah. And you know, like, if you get water in your ear, then sounds suddenly... There was so much spit in my ear that happened.
Go on, what was your exit strategy from this then?
Well, no, I it was really just to kind of politely sort of go, oh yeah, no, that makes sense. Yeah, that's a decent proposal. You should definitely write that up. I'm just going to the toilet now. I'll be back in a minute. And then a calm, collected walk.
Don't run.
And then as soon as the door opened, run to the sink, like, get this out of my ear.
Purge.
It's a dangerous world, conferences. Yes.